Good morning, welcome to my channel, Guide to Keto. I've lost 181 pounds on a ketogenic journey. I have been crazy stalled. My inches had gone down. I made it back into 197, and then kept flipping back and forth to 200. My blood sugars were crazy, and we're talking about 11 total carbs. We're talking about not doing fat bombs. We're talking about not eating vegetables. Like, we cut everything down. And then all of a sudden, I went back on the metformin because I was having issues with my sugars. 9 a week on the metformin, and I cannot take the nausea that it causes. So yesterday, I stopped it. Also, I gained to 210 in a week after taking the metformin. I don't know if it's because of the nausea. I don't know what the heck it was. But I know I woke up this morning at 212. My weight is going up and up every single day. And I really didn't eat yesterday. As you saw, the last couple of days, it's been extremely hard to eat anything because of being so sick. Like, insanely sick. So, y'all might think this is completely insane and the dumbest thing to do in the world. But I'm going to show you what I did like an hour ago or 2 hours ago. But I did come home and I worked outside with a hoe and a garden shovel and really burned some energy, like insane amount of energy and sweat. So let me roll that little clip. And it's all I've had to eat today. So I am in Walmart shopping. And my daughter wanted Dunkin' Donuts, and I figured, hey, I've gone up like 20 pounds this week. Literally, y'all, you would not believe it. I stepped on the scale and I was freaking out. That's with no cheats, no nothing. It had to be that metformin. It's not supposed to do that. And I felt like throwing up again. I decided to have a donut with her. I feel a little high, to be honest. I have not had real sugar since December 26th. I feel really weird, but the nausea is gone, but no, I'm not going to start eating carbs, and I don't regret it because I don't have nausea right now, and on top of it, it's my birthday tomorrow, and I'm not having a cheat meal, so that was my cheat, one donut. Okay, so, yes, I had a donut. I had my favorite donut. It actually was not that good. I wished I just had some french fries or something, but it is my birthday. And it has been 3 years. This would have been my third birthday without getting any birthday cakes, anything. Tomorrow is my birthday, but my daughter has to stay at school really late. So we decided to go to Dunkin' Donuts, and she also got a coffee. I did not get the coffee because that would have been more sugar. I just ate the donut, and it gave me a sugar high. Surprisingly, it only raised my blood sugar the amount it would have if you're not a diabetic. If you have no insulin resistance and you go eat a donut, that's what my sugar rose to, 120 something. But I don't eat sugar, so it was weird. Like I said, the nausea was gone after eating it. I'm still not nauseous. I was able to go outside and work in the yard. And yeah, I did it because the weight is going up every day no matter what. But that's the only cheat I'm doing. That's it. I really, really wanted my favorite dinner tomorrow, but I'm not. I have some wings I'm about to go cook. I don't put anything on them but some salt on mine. So yeah, I might regret it tomorrow. I don't know. I don't know why the scale is climbing like it is. Like, I don't know. I'm not eating those fat bombs. I stopped eating the pork rinds. I had only ate the 1 tablespoon of coconut flour. I cut down to like 2 or 3 drops of monk fruit, 2 or 3 of the extract, which has no sugar in it at all. 1 tablespoon of coconut flour, unless it's the xanthan gum, which I shouldn't be having an issue of. It's 1/8 of a teaspoon of xanthan gum. And that's been it. That's the only areas I have any carbs. I even took the heavy whipping cream away. Like, what else can I take from my diet? Like, keto worked amazing for 181 pounds. Now I'm starting to go up again. This happened last year. And then I had a big whoosh and I lost all the weight, so maybe that's what's happening. I'm having trouble breathing. I don't feel well. I just want to finally get to my goal weight and just maintain so I don't have to worry about it anymore. That's all I want to do. I want to get there and just maintain. But I think that's going to take more than a year. I don't know. Because that was the goal this year, to get those last 50 pounds off. But instead, I'm right back where I was in December. Oh, and my stomach's very swollen. I'm glad I did not have to do those streams today. Because after yesterday, my stomach is like gigantically swollen. That's why I said, the heck with it. I'm going to eat that donut. And I'm not going to feel guilty because my weight's being stupid anyways. And why feel deprived on my birthday? And it's not even working right this minute. But I'm having wings tonight. No hot sauce, no nothing, just salt. Had the donut. Now we're moving back to keto food only. So I don't see anything wrong with, I have been strict keto since December 27th. And I was not going to do it, but my weight went, like, what is with that? It's my body. It's not keto. It is not. And it could be because I've also cut down my heart meds. I'm trying to get off my heart meds. And my heart's not pumping all the fluid off like it normally would. So that could be an issue. And no, I don't take water pills. I can't. I'm allergic. I wish I wasn't so shy, or I would go sit in the sauna at the gym. But I don't want to go sit in there by myself. I don't know. And with the whole coronavirus going on, I'm sure it's not there, but that would seem like a scary place. You're in this heat room, sealed in, and I don't know. But, so I did. I went to Walmart, and I got a garden hoe, a garden rake. That was $20. I got me a pair of gloves for $5, and I got me some guys' oak moss boots. Like, outdoor boots are normally like $60-something dollars. On clearance for $15. I'm like, why would I get girls and pay the normal price because they're not on sale when I'm just using it to do yard work? So I went and got the men's. I got a 9 and accidentally grabbed the wrong box, so it's 9 wide. I have narrow feet. So I'm like tying them as tight as possible and putting extra socks on. But they work, okay? They keep the snakes away from me, ticks off of me, and whatever else, and don't get sunk down in the mud. Like, they're okay to get all muddy because they're waterproof. So, yeah. So I'm going to stop rambling. I will show you my wings when I eat them. And the weight will go away sooner or later. The more hot it gets outside, the more my weight will fall off. I don't know why it's being stupid. I don't know why it's going up right now. I am sure it'll go up tomorrow because I did have a donut. So we're just going to keep moving along and keep being keto. I also wanted to show y'all my little coffee mug I got for $5 at Walmart. It is so adorable. I don't even know if I'm going to use it for coffee or to put pens in. But, oh my gosh, I love Ariel. And this is like the prettiest cup I've ever seen them have for $5. I had to have it. So those oak moss shoes I got on clearance for $15, I just had to have. So they're going to do their job. I'm not wearing them out in public. I mean, they're cute enough if they were my size, but they're a little too big. But they're great for working in the yard. Hey, like I said, after that donut, it's time for keto food because we're going right back on track. This is my daughter's mashed potato cauliflower with some Kerrygold butter, cheese, and sour cream. And her wings, her boyfriend's, and then mine. I'm having 5 wings. So yeah, back to keto.